to talk about indeterminate forms. So this has come up earlier when we were talking about taking limits of things like 0 over 0 or infinity over infinity. And up until this point, we have used algebra to try to take something out of an indeterminate form and into something that we can actually work with. So remember things like, you know, if you had 0 over 0, you might factor and cancel something. You might multiply by a conjugate, something like that. Infinity over infinity, you almost always multiplied through by 1 over x to a power. And so the question for this video is, why were these indeterminate forms? And if I come across a new form in a limit, something that's not exactly a number, but maybe I should know what the number it is. How do I know if I get an answer or if I get indeterminate? So what we're going to do is just kind of go through a whole bunch of examples and kind of talk through what you're looking for when you're trying to determine if a form is indeterminate. Before we do that, though, a few basics. Rules about dealing with infinity. Now, infinity is not a number, and we can't really treat it like one, but there's some things that we can say about infinity. If you take infinity and you add a number to it, you're taking the biggest thing possible and you're making it even bigger, it's still going to be infinity. Same thing about if you take infinity and you subtract a regular number that's not infinity. This regular number just doesn't compete with the infinity. You still get infinity. If you take infinity and you multiply it by any number at all, or even if you divide it by some number, as long as you're not dividing by zero, that's still going to be infinity. Half of the biggest thing ever is still the biggest thing ever. The problem comes in when we start combining multiple infinities in the same problem, or when we start combining infinity and zero in a problem. There's also a couple times when even something so as innocent looking as one combined with infinity can be confusing. So let's look at some of these examples of forms, things that the limit could look like while you're trying to simplify it, and see if we can figure out whether we should be able to determine what the answer is or whether they're also indeterminate. And we need to know more. We need to know how it gets to infinity or how it gets to zero before we can actually say what the answer is. Okay, first, a non-zero number divided by zero. This is something like 7 divided by zero, and this is something that we looked at earlier in this class. So 7 divided by 0, that means you have 7 over smaller and smaller numbers coming from both sides. So these could be plus or minus. So what's happening there, as the bottom gets smaller, the top stays the same and the fraction gets bigger. This is going to be infinity, negative infinity, or does not exist. Remember, this is a vertical asymptote on the graph. And so we know if you're approaching it from just one side, you're either going up or down. But if you're coming from both sides, you could have any combination of these two things. So you could have up on this side and down on that side, which would lead to a does not exist type answer. But this is not indeterminate. Even though we have to look a little bit harder to determine if it's infinity, negative infinity, or does not exist, we're not going to call this indeterminate. Next, we have a number divided by infinity. So this is something like 7 over infinity. So 7 hundredths, 7 thousandths, 7 millionths. This is getting really small. This is going to 0. Now, 0 over 0, this is interesting. Now we have a little bit of a conflict because the 0 on the top of the fraction is trying to make the answer 0. 0 times anything, any number, right, equals 0. Dividing by 0 in the bottom is not the same thing as be multiplying by a number. So even though we think the answer should be 0 because of the top, it isn't necessarily, because dividing by 0 on the bottom, what did we just say up here? We said dividing by 0 in the bottom should make the answer either infinity, negative infinity, or does not exist. So we're going to call these a type of infinity. From now on, I'm just going to write this as plus or minus infinity, and you remember that it also could not exist. So what does this mean? This means that It might be zero. It might be infinity. And how am I supposed to be able to tell? Right? I have two possible answers, and I can't tell. It all depends on how quickly this top gets to zero and how quickly this bottom is trying to make the answer infinity. Whichever one is doing it faster, being closer to its limiting value for smaller values of x, that one is likely going to win. But it might be even that none of them win. You could do something like the limit as x goes to zero of 5x over 2x. That's zero over zero. But we know we can just cancel those x's, right? We cancel the x's and we get 5/2. We could have put any numbers here in these coefficients, right? We can actually get any answer to zero over zero, and that's why it's indeterminate. For zero divided by infinity, the top of the fraction is trying to make the answer zero. Like we said before, zero times anything is zero. But the bottom of the answer is divided by infinity. So if you make the bottom of a fraction really, really big, you're making the whole answer go towards zero. So in this case, both of these want the answer to be zero, which means there's no conflict. And this is not an indeterminate form. This really does just go to zero. What about infinity over infinity? Well, infinity over infinity, the top, you multiply anything by infinity and you should get infinity. But if you, the bottom, if you divide anything by infinity, you ought to get zero. So again, here we have a conflict. Infinity and zero are not the same. So we have an indeterminate form. What about infinity divided by zero? Well, infinity over zero, the infinity on top is obviously trying to make the answer infinity. But the zero on the bottom, well, remember when we divide by zero, we talked about this before, we should get some kind of infinity, plus or minus infinity. So this is another example, like at a vertical asymptote, where our answer is going to be infinity, negative infinity, or does not exist. And it just depends on the signs. For a non-zero number times infinity, like 3 times infinity, we already said that that was going to be infinity. For infinity times infinity, if you take something really, really big and you multiply it by something else really, really big, it's going to be really, really big. Or another way of thinking about that is, this infinity is trying to make the answer infinity. This infinity is trying to make the answer infinity. These are equal, there's no conflict, so that's our answer. For zero times infinity, zero times anything is trying to make the answer zero. Infinity times anything is trying to make the answer infinity. So this zero and this infinity, they're not equal. We're trying to approach two different things. It's like a tug of war. Is it more zero-y or more infinity, or is it somewhere stuck in the middle? So this one is indeterminate. For infinity plus a number, we just talked about that. Infinity plus 3. You add 3 to infinity, it doesn't really change it at all. You just get infinity. For infinity plus infinity, if you take anything and you add infinity to it, you ought to get infinity. This infinity is also trying to make the answer infinity. So there's no conflict here. This really is just infinity. For infinity minus infinity, though, it's a little bit more interesting. This first infinity is trying to make the answer infinity, right? If you had infinity minus something else, you'd get infinity. But this infinity, since it's negative, if this was like 7 minus infinity, we'd get negative infinity. So this infinity wants the answer to be negative infinity. These are not the same. So they're pulling in opposite directions, and this is an indeterminate form. Infinity raised to the infinity. Take something really big, raise it to a really big positive power, and you're going to get something even bigger. But if this really big thing is as big as possible, then you're just still going to get infinity. Zero to the zero, you've got 0 raised to any power. What is that? It should be 0, right? 0 cubed is 0. 0 to the 5th is 0. Any number raised to the 0th power is supposed to be 1. And in fact, by definition, we even say that 0 to the 0 as a number is 1. But for limits, if we're approaching 0 on top and approaching 0 in the exponent, we can't say which of these is going to win. So this is indeterminate. For infinity to the 0, you can probably guess that this is also going to be an issue, because infinity raised to a positive power, infinity squared, infinity cubed, that ought to go to infinity, right? Infinity to a negative power. Remember what a negative power does, right? That's actually 1 over. It's 1 over infinity to a positive power. So 1 over infinity, that's actually 0. So if we're approaching 0 here, and we're a little bit, we're positive, we should be getting towards infinity. If we're negative, we should be getting towards 0. And if we're exactly at 0, anything to the 0, remember, was 1. So this one actually has 3 different answers that it's trying to be. And so, of course, that means it's indeterminate. 1 to the 0, well, 1 to any power should be 1. Anything to the 0 should be 1. So this isn't an issue. There's no conflict. This really is just 1. 0 to the infinity. This one is interesting. Now, it doesn't really make sense to talk about a negative number raised to something and then taking the limit of that something, because that limit's not going to exist. It's going to keep fluctuating back and forth between positive and negative, and it might even be trying to take square roots of negatives. But if we're talking about from the positive side, so we're talking about something bigger than 0 to the infinity, then remember, if we're bigger than 0 but close to 0, then that actually does make sense. Because if you take any fraction, like a half, and you raise it to the infinity, well, a half squared is a fourth, half cubed is an eighth, half to the fourth is a 16th. It's getting smaller and smaller and smaller, and this is going to go to 0. And for any number inside here between 0 and 1, it's going to go to 0. So we can say that 0 to the infinity goes to 0 if you're coming from the positive side. And then the last one here is 1 to the infinity. And this one looks like it shouldn't be a big deal. If you literally take the limit as x goes to infinity of 1 to the x, you're going to get, well, 1 raised to the 100th power is 1, 1 raised to the millionth power is 1, 1 raised to the trillionth power is 1. So this is really 1. But when you have something that's just approaching 1, like 1 plus 1 over x to the x, then it gets tricky. Because this goes to 1 plus 0, 1 over infinity is 0, goes to 0, raised to the infinity, which is going to go to the form 1 to the infinity. But this is something bigger than 1 in here, because this is a positive number. Anything bigger than 1, something like 2 or even 1.1, anything bigger than 1 raised to the infinity is going to go to infinity. But we just said in the previous problem that anything less than 1, so anything between 0 and 1, like a half raised to the infinity, goes to 0. So 1 here is kind of a borderline case. And so, again, because we could have arguments for 3 different answers, 1 to the infinity is indeterminate. Now remember, these are not actual things. These are all forms. And anytime I say something like 1 to the infinity, I mean if you take a limit and it has the form 1 to the infinity. 1 to the infinity is by itself not a number. It doesn't really mean anything. This whole conversation only makes sense in the context of limits.